so much, and I also would like to begin by acknowledging that we are here on the land of the Gadigal people of the Eora Nation and pay our respects to their elders, past, present and emerging, and acknowledge any Aboriginal people that are here with us today. It always was and always will be Aboriginal land, and if there was anybody that had the right to say who gets to come to this country and the circumstances in which they come, it should be those First Nations people. I would really like to acknowledge Majid, the artist, people like us, the incredible people that have put this on, Fabia, Amir, Saba, for your amazing words. And I would also like to acknowledge our Greens councillor, Lynn Saville from Willoughby Council, who's here, and past councillors that would be still councils if we didn't sack our councillors, because of course of our nation, so that's a whole other story. I'd like to acknowledge people that have come from near and far to join us today, because I think if there was ever a movement, if there was ever a human rights issue where we feel we need a bit of hope and a bit of inspiration, then it is the treatment of asylum seekers and refugees in this country. And I can say that I feel genuinely inspired and warmed by the fact that we have wonderful people and such incredible activists here, community leaders and community representatives from across this great city here with us today. So thank you all for coming. It means a lot. It might be a bit controversial, but I just wanted to remind people about the origins of Harmony Day. Because believe it or not, the concept of Harmony Day or Harmony Week might sound like it's a wonderful thing that you could never object to and that you could never have an issue with. But it is important to remember that the concept of Harmony Day actually, and it was over 15 years ago, I believe, when our then Prime Minister John Howard was getting a bit of heat about racial division and multiculturalism in our society, that all of a sudden the United Nations Day for the Elimination of Racial Discrimination was repackaged, if you like, as Harmony Day. And it's not to criticise what Harmony Day has become and what harmony is all about, because I think we would all agree that there is always a need for us to celebrate and welcome and enjoy the multicultural society that is there. But I think it's really important for us also to remember that this day and this celebration came from a recognition of a problem. And that problem is racial discrimination. And that problem is still there in this country and around the world. And so while we must come together and celebrate Harmony Day, and it usually involves people talking about fine food and various types of wine and cultural festivities and celebration, we must also remember that there is a problem here. And that's why we need Harmony Day. And that problem is that we still have racial discrimination in this country, and we still have racial discrimination in our world. And I think it's really important in that context to remember, and I'll just read you from the United Nations theme for the 2017 United Nations Day of Elimination and of Racial Discrimination. And the theme this year is racial profiling and the incitement to hatred, including in the context of migration. And I think that is a really relevant theme for us here in Australia and what we see day to day. And I'll just read you a small bit of what they say. Refugees and migrants are particular targets of racial profiling and incitement of hatred. In the New York Declaration for Refugees and Migrants, adopted in September 2016, United Nations member states strongly condemned acts of manifestations of racism, racial discrimination, xenophobia and related intolerance against refugees and migrants, and committed to a range of steps to counter such attitudes and behaviours, especially regarding hate crimes, hate speech and racial violence. I think it's important to put that out there, because while we come together and offer a welcome message, and the work that people like us do is incredible for its positive positioning and its amazing connection with beautiful people around this country who actually want to open their hearts, it is important for us to remember that at the end of the day, what we are facing here is a form of racial discrimination that needs to be addressed. And until we address that underlying cause of racial discrimination in this country, the plight of refugees and asylum seekers will be one that we will never win, because people will be okay about locking up other people in the most inhumane of conditions. And so I can give you my pledge that as a representative for one of the most progressive areas in this city, as a representative of the Greens, but also as someone who, as Valia described, is very much an accidental activist that only finds herself in this position because of John Howard's divisive policies on refugees all those years ago. I can give you my pledge that I will continue to work with you and with other refugee activist groups until we see everybody brought here, until we see the camps closed, and until we see a humane and just treatment of asylum seekers in this country and around the world. Thank you so much.